In this video, let us study about the voltage divider or the potential divider circuit. So this is that circuit which divides the larger value of voltage into smaller value. So this actually involves applying voltage source across the resistors that are connected in series combination. So let us consider that circuit here. So this is a voltage source. Now it is applied, okay, that is across the resistors that are connected in series. Now these two are the resistors R1 R2, and this is a voltage source V. The current flowing through this circuit, let that be I. Why this is a series? Because there is only one path for the current to flow, then hence it is called as series combination. Now if I apply KVL to this, then what happens? See, we can mark the potential drops here. Since the current is flowing in this direction, this will be plus and this will be minus. And here, since it is flowing in this direction, this is plus and this is minus. Okay, so we will apply the, that is KVL here. See, V, since we are getting minus first, it is plus V. Then since we are getting plus first, that will be minus I R1. Then minus I into R2, that is equal to 0. This is by KVL. So V is equal to IR1 plus IR2. Okay. So taking I common, R1 plus R2. Why I is common? Because this is series combination and there is only one path for the current to flow. So I will be equal to V divided by R1 plus R2. So this is the value of current. Now if we have to find the voltage across the resistor R1, that will be equal to I into R1, that is from Ohm's law. Now substituting this value, we get VR1 as V into R1 divided by R1 plus R2. Similarly, if we have to find the voltage drop across R2, VR2 will be equal to I into R2. That means substituting the value of I, we get V divided by R1 plus R2 into R2. That means from this we can conclude that the voltage drop across any resistor, that is equal to the ratio of that particular resistance across which the voltage drop has to be measured, okay, divided by the equivalent resistance. Equivalent resistance multiplied by the source voltage V. Okay, ratio of resistance divided, that is to the equivalent resistance multiplied by the source voltage. Okay, so this is now R2 across R2, how to measure the voltage drop, that is VR2. So R2 divided by R1 plus R2. This is the series combination. So we can consider R equivalent as R1 plus R2. Okay, so this is nothing but R equivalent. So this is the voltage divider circuit. So we can also apply this to n number of resistors connected in series. So if we have another resistor R3 here, okay, then it becomes V is equal to I into R1 plus R2 plus R3. Then I will be equal to V divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3. So this will be your equivalent resistance because all the three resistors are connected in series. So what will be the voltage drop across R3? That will be the ratio of that particular resistance across which the voltage drop is being measured divided by equivalent resistance into the supply voltage V. Similarly, VR2 will be equal to ratio of the resistance across which the voltage drop is measured divided by equivalent resistance into supply voltage V. Okay, similarly, VR1 is equal to V into R1 divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3. This is the voltage divider circuit. Mm-hmm.